Hey guys, Fuad here from beattweaks.com. In this video, we're going to go through a quick example of mixing a kick drum in a track. And the point of this example is to address something that a lot of producers have trouble with, and that is mid-side processing. So that includes mid-side EQ, or just the balance of the mids and the sides in general, or even what are mids and what are sides. So this is something that gives a lot of producers trouble, and we're going to address it in this quick little example. So first of all, before we start, I just want to say that mixing is a problem-solving process. So if you think about it that way and you approach it that way, your mixing life is going to be so much easier and you're going to get a lot better sounding songs in the end. So instead of just approaching mixing where you just throw plugins on there and kind of hope for the best and figure things out as you go along, if you approach it as a problem solving process, then every time you listen to an instrument, you think to yourself, okay, what am I listening to? What am I trying to achieve? And how do I go about achieving that? So approach mixing that way, and I promise your songs will sound so much better. Okay, so let's go through this example. So this is a song that I'm mixing and mastering for a producer. And for some reason, for whatever reason, the kick drum has reverb on it. So I was sent this track. I was sent all these tracks, all the instruments in the song, and the kick drum has reverb on it. And not even just a little bit of reverb, but a lot of reverb. So you might face that issue where there's a sample and you really like it, but it's just something weird is going on. Either it has a delay on it, or it's got reverb on it, or it's got some other noise around it, and you kind of want to clean it up. So this is a great example of where we can use things like mid-side processing and mid-side EQ to kind of try to clean up the sound a little bit, and hopefully at the same time, this will demystify mid-side for you. So let's listen to the kick drum on its own. Right, so it's got a lot of reverb on it. The kick drum itself sounds really good. It's really punchy, it's really strong, and it's just a good sounding kick drum. Okay, so how do we approach this? So we have a problem here, reverb on a kick drum. So when it comes to reverb, most of the time, 99% of the time, reverb is in the side portion of the signal. So you've got a side portion, which is everything literally in the sides, and then you have a mid portion, which is everything that is mono. So mid-side is mono and stereo. So the sides are whatever is in stereo, everything that's nice and wide, and that's what reverb usually is. So I'm going to show you two approaches to addressing this problem. The first one is we're going to use a free plugin from Voxengo, and it's called MSED. And this is a really cool plugin because it splits the signal into mid and side, and then you can mute the mids or mute the sides, so you can listen to only what's in stereo, or you can listen to only what's in mono. So that's cool. The second thing you can do is you can actually turn up or down the gain of either the sides or the mids, so you can actually rebalance the mono and stereo balance, or the mid-side balance of your track. Now, in this situation, I don't want any reverb on the kick, so I can actually just go and mute the sides. So let's listen to what that does. So what this did is it got rid of everything that's in the side portion of the signal. Now, if we mute the mids, then we will just be able to hear the reverb on this kick. So there you go. That's one step of addressing this problem. So we can start by muting the sides, and already we've gotten rid of a big portion of the problem. So another way to approach this is using mid-side EQ. We can achieve a similar effect using mid-side EQ. So in Ableton Live, my EQ here has a stereo mode, a left and right mode, and a mid-side mode. So if I click mid-side mode, I can switch between EQing the mids and the sides independently of each other. So I'm just going to turn off this MSED plugin for a second. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch this to the side mode. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to EQ out. I'm going to pretty much filter everything in the side portion of the kick. And let's listen to what that did. So it pretty much did the same thing. And then you can compare and see which one sounds better or if there actually is a difference at all. So they pretty much sound exactly the same. So if you're using mid-side EQ, what you can do is completely filter out everything in the sides, and then you can just EQ your kick like you normally do, of course, while listening to it with the rest of the track. But what you would do is you would switch over to the mids, because that's where the meat, that's where the main body of the kick is, and then that's what you would use to EQ the kick. And there you go. That's a quick example of how to use mid-side processing to solve a problem like a reverb on a kick drum. This can apply to so many different things. You can, for example, use this on a melody loop that also has too much reverb or delay that you don't want there. This will help you reduce that, and then it'll clean it up and it'll sound better in your mix. It won't muddy up your mix. So this is an example that you can apply to many, many different things. Drum loops, bass loops, synth loops, percussion loops, and all kinds of different things.